So Joshua Reynolds was one of the most popular portraitists of his time. Some of his portraits consisted of famous beauties of 18th century society.
There seems to be lots of questions surrounding the identity of these ladies. So we were curious to find out more. So we decided to interview Lucy and Alex, who work as experts in the Wallace Collection.
Welcome, Lucy. So who was Mrs. Nesbit?
So Mrs. Nesbit was quite a fascinating character. She was born Mary Davis, or Polly Davis, she was also known as, and she started off as a courtesan in Covent Garden. But she married a very wealthy merchant banker called Alexander Nesbit. And she then moved to his house in Norwood and enjoyed a very sort of wealthy lifestyle. While she was married to him, she allegedly started having an affair with an aristocrat, the third Earl of Bristol.
Oh dear.
And on his death, he left her a huge amount of money and property. And in the meantime, her husband, Alexander Nesbit, died, and it was said that he was actually driven insane by her infidelity. Who knows what the truth really
of
was?
So what attracted her to Reynolds to commission such a painting?
Well, Reynolds was the leading portrait painter in Britain in the second half of the 18th century, and he, I think, also was just very good at painting female sitters. By this stage, he was the most famous, he was really the leading portraitist of the day, and he'd already painted many sort of celebrities as well, Georgian beauties, and really everybody, all kinds of different people, writers, politicians, and very sort of glamorous women like actresses and courtesans like Mrs. Nesbit herself.
So he was the go-to person.
He was the go-to portraitist of the day, absolutely.
Well, Lucy was able to tell us all about Mrs. Nesbit because she is an expert on Reynolds. But we thought that about Nellie O'Brien, we'd ask Alex, who has worked as a conservator on the painting, because we think she might be able to tell us both about Nellie herself and also about the structure of the painting. Who was Nellie O'Brien?
Nellie O'Brien was a courtesan, so she made her money by selling herself to men. But she also worked as a model, and Reynolds was friends with her and used her on a number of occasions to paint.
And why is this portrait of Nellie so different from lots of others that Reynolds painted?
It's a really interesting portrait because Reynolds has painted her looking straight out, and she's also wearing a big wide-brimmed hat, and so her face is in shadow. And this is one of the most interesting images because of that shadowed face and her looking straight at you.
And you're a conservator at the Wallace, and we know that you worked on this painting for a long time.
Yes.
What did you discover about it?
It was painted using a number of pigments that have faded over time. So she's wearing that amazing quilted pink petticoat, and it looks pink still because it has some of the pigment vermilion in it, but it also has a pigment which is red lake, and that's faded slightly. So the colours are not exactly as they would have been when Reynolds painted it. And also on either side of the sitter, there's some areas that have really badly cracked, and this we think is because Reynolds was using a material that didn't dry very quickly, and as the top paint layers dried, the layers underneath have come up through the cracks and have made a strange appearance in those areas.
From these portraits, we can see the difference between Reynolds' commissioned work and his own.
Reynolds was very experimental for his time and enjoyed the freedom that painting uncommissioned works gave him.
Nellie O'Brien and Mrs. Nesbit are on display here at the Wallace Collection.